In this video, we're going to cover the concepts of sets in GTAP and their logic. It's an important chapter in teaching the courses of the GTAP. Please bear in mind that this video is more relevant for the audience who is using the GTAP model version 6.2 or earlier. However, the logics in version 7 and beyond do apply to what is going to be covered in this video. The sets in GTAP and their logic are important to understanding the data picture of the economy described in the GTAP world. But before we move to economic concepts relevant to the GTAP dimensions, let's first think about dimensions of any object you can see or imagine. Close your eyes and think about TVs, tables, and chairs in your room. Some more straightforward examples are cubes and cuboids, which are all three-dimensional shapes that categorize the length, width, and height of each object. Moving to sets and dimensions in economics and global trade, now these objects are economic activities. For example, the left-hand side shows a bundle of goods or commodities, and the right-hand side shows where the activities that have taken place. We can say China buys corn from the United States, or likewise, we may say Germany imports copper from Chile. In GTAP, we have a world collection of economic commodities that are produced and shipped around the world. We also have countries of origin and the destination, which are suppliers and those who consume those products. Finally, let's bring these concepts into the GTAP model. What have been most commonly seen in the standard GTAP model are the demanded commodities and model regions. The commodities being demanded consists of endowment such as labor, capital, and land, and traded commodities that are being produced and exported, such as corn and soybeans. And the model regions include source regions where the goods are produced and supplied from, and the destination regions where the goods are delivered to. More quantitatively, we may use the letter I to denote traded commodity or tradcom, whereas the letter R represents the region. So what we're seeing here in the parentheses are called quantifiers. The first one says that there would be one formula or equation for every commodity I in the set tradcom. Again, the tradcom may include elements such as corn and soybeans. Similarly, the second quantifier says that there will be one formula or equation for every region R in the set region. And lastly, PIM is the variable name meaning market price, which actually in Tableau is the percent change of market price. So PIM IR means percent change of market price of imported goods I in region R. So here's a larger picture of the relevant sets in the standard GTAP. On one hand, the capital commodity and traded commodity are the two subsets of the commodity being produced. Again, this only applies to the classic version of the GTAP. The version 7 does not have capital goods and does not distinguish commodities from activities, and has an additional sector-specific endowment set. For the new version, some endowment sets are being determined at runtime, either from reading the file or based on set operations. From top to bottom, as we saw earlier, there are two subsets in the demanded commodities, which are endowment commodities and traded commodities. Endowment commodity includes sluggish and mobile endowment, and traded commodity includes margin and non-margin commodity. Here are some examples that show how the subsets are related to sets as syntax in the Tableau file, which you will probably encounter at some point later. The union and plus signs are equivalent. You can say the produced commodity equals traded commodity union capital commodity, or you can say endowment commodity equals sluggish commodity plus mobile endowment. Now we want to give you some quick exercises to see if you have mastered the basics of this lecture. There are three questions. You're welcome to pause the video and answer each question. And the answers are in the next slide following each question. The first one, match the following quantifiers with the correct letter defined in the relevant set. Here's the answer. Again, please feel free to pause and see if you got the right one. Here's the second question. Given that QXS represents percent change of export sales, here comes the answer. Now here's the third question. Again, please pause if needed. Here's the answer. Have you got them all right? Now we want to tell you how to locate the sets and set files from the Analyze GE. This can be handy when you implement the GTAP. From the top, follow where it's highlighted with the red circle and check the directory. Next, please go to the directory shown in the previous slide and look for the sets file. And here we go. By double-clicking each row, you'll find out what elements are in each set. One other thing we want to tell you is that there are extensions of GTAP models out there that have non-standard sets. But if you follow the logic in this video, it will not be difficult for you to figure out others. Thanks for watching, and we hope you enjoyed this video. If you have any questions, please send them through the GTAP L, and we'll be more than happy to help.